Good morning, everyone. Is my voice audible to you? Am I audible? Hello. Am I audible to you? Okay, thank you. Okay, so today I will be taking only your detritus tank and your skimming tank. And these two part I will take for today, and for Friday we will be doing your nicely your sedimentation part, because that is a bit long. Okay, I don't want to end it even halfway, so like we will start the sedimentation part on Friday. So is my screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So today after we have studied your grit chamber, if you can remember last class we have studied about the grit chamber. So next is your, after your grit chamber treatment, that is, you know, collection of grits and all that is done in your grit chamber. So after your grit chamber, we have the detritus tank. Okay, so please try to remember the names and the work of each of its items. Okay, like what is a grit chamber, what is a screening do, and what is the, you know, ascending process. Like first process is screening, after that your comes your grit chamber. So you remember like this. Okay, so somebody sometimes in Viva, if it might be asked you like what is the process or what is the you know, serial way in which the treatment is done. So you should remember the names, okay, and also the words. So this detritus tank, after it comes after your grit chamber, and this detritus tank, you know, it is a similar kind of, you know, it is a kind of grit chamber only, and it is a rectangular in shape. These detritus tanks are rectangular grit chambers also, you can see. So these are named as detritus tanks because, you know, these have very small velocity, okay, and it has a very long detention period. So if I say a smaller flow velocity, that means it flows in a very, you know, it flows very slow, and it has a velocity of about, you can say, 0.09 meter per second. And also it has a very long retention period. So you have to keep it for a very long time. You have to settle the water or the wastewater for a very long time. That is for about like 3 to 4 minutes, okay? And this detritus tank, you know, it not only separates the, you know, only the grits or the larger grits or debris, whatever it's there, but also it will separate your, you know, very, very fine sand particles. So it's this detritus tank, it separates out both the fine particles or and the, you know, the large particles, okay? That is your grits and all also it will separate, and along with that it will separate the very fine that sand particles also. Then, you know, due to this, what is happening, a very large amount of this organic matters, they will, you know, settle down. Okay, along with the grits will obviously, it will settle down in this detritus tank if you keep it for a very longer detention period. So along with the these grits, okay, this organic matter will also, they will tend to settle down. Okay, and this organic material, you know, it will be, you know, separated from the grit by doing some, you know, by providing some currents in the tank. Okay, a current is passed through the tank so that what happens, you know, like, and the aeration is also given. Okay, aeration, that means oxygen is also supplied. So with the, when you know, like this oxygen is supplied, what happens, that some air bubbles will start rising. Okay, so these air bubbles, you know, they separate the, you know, the lighter organic matter that are present in the tank. Okay, and these you know, this grit, it is the grits whichever is formed, so these are, you know, continuously they are being removed by a you know, like scraper. So with the help of a scraper, the grit is continuously, it is being removed. So the you know, detritus tank, it is a similar the mechanism, working mechanism is similar with that of a grit chamber. Okay, rectangular grit chamber, everything is same, only here you have to know that the flow velocity, it is very less, that is your 0.09 meter per second, and the detention period is about 3 to 4 minutes. So suppose if a you know, design numerical is given to you stating that you have to design the dimensions of a detritus tank, and you know, no values are given to you as like the detention periods is not given or the flow velocity is not given, then you can assume the detention period as your 3 to 4 minutes, and also the flow velocity as your 0.09 meter per second. Okay, so next is your, like, it is a numerical. Let us do or see a numerical related to your detritus tank. So the question, it goes like, design a suitable grit chamber, come detritus tank for a sewage treatment plant getting a dry weather flow from a separate sewerage system at 400 liter per second. Assume the flow velocity through the tank as 0.2 meter per second and retention period of 2 minutes. The maximum flow may be assumed to be 3 times of the dry weather flow. Okay, so here, just a second. Okay, in the given question, you know, here what it is given you you know, the discharge is given to you, that is your 400 liter per second. Then your velocity, flow velocity is given to you, that is your 0.2 meter per second. Then also your detention period is also provided to you, that is 2 minutes, it's already given. So you no need to assume now. Okay, and they have given you to, you know, the maximum flow may be assumed to be 3 times of dry weather flow. First of all, what is dry weather flow? dry weather flow, you can say it is the like average daily flow, okay? It is the average daily flow during the period of, you can say, no rain. When there is no rain, so what is the average, you know, the flow taking place daily to suppose a wastewater, to a wastewater treatment plant. So that is, you know, known as your dry weather flow, that is during the, you know, season of no rain, okay? So what is, first of all, we have to, you know, since velocity and your retention time is given to you. Okay, so since your velocity, yes, velocity is given to you, and also your detention period is given to you, that is your 2 minutes, okay, and flow velocity as 0.2 meter per second. So if you you know that to find the length of the tank, so if you multiply both your velocity and detention time, so you will be getting your length of the tank, okay. So velocity is given as your 0.2, and it is detention period is given as 2 minutes. So 2 minutes you have to convert into seconds, obviously, because your the other parameter, that is your velocity, it is in meter per second. Okay, so you have to convert it to minutes to second. So first, to find out the length of the tank, just multiply both your detention period and your velocity of the tank. So by doing so, you get the answer as your 24 meter. Okay, so the length of the tank you have found out. So now it is given to you that you have to assume the maximum flow, you know, as your 3 times the dry weather flow. It is given to you in the question. So we have to, you know, like, since it is given 3 times the dry weather flow, so we can provide three chambers, or you can say 3 detritus tanks we can provide. Okay, so each detritus tank, they will provide the dry weather flow. So by through each of the tank or through each of the chamber, so the dry weather flow will be passing by. Okay, so the discharge, now it is given to you in the question that it is your through each tank, what is the discharge? It is your 400 liter per second. That is your, if you convert it to second meter cube per second, so it is your 0.4 meter cube per second. Okay, now you have to find out, you have to find out the width of the tank and also the depth of the tank. But the depth you can assume in case of your grid chamber, since depth is not given to you and you cannot find out the depth here, so you can assume for the grid chamber. We have already discussed that you can assume that water depth to be around like 1.2 meter. Okay, so here you can assume the water depth as 1.2 meter, and you can, after having the water depth, you can find the width of the tank. But for finding the width of the tank, again, you need the area. Okay, so you have to first find out the area of the tank, and what is the area? Discharge by velocity. Okay, so discharge you have and velocity also you have, so you find out the area, that is your 2 meters squared. Okay, so now you have assumed the depth as your 1.2 meter. So now you can find the width of the tank. So width of the tank is what? Area by depth. Okay. So area by depth, if you do, so you will get your width of the detritus tank. So finally, the detritus tank, it is of like 24 meter by 1.7 meter by 1.2 meter. 1.2 meter is the depth. Okay. But this depth, you know, it is not the final depth. It is the depth of the what? It is the depth of the tank, okay? So now we have to find the overall depth of the tank, okay? So the last class already I told you that you have to provide a freeboard, okay? So you have to provide at the top, you have to provide a freeboard, and also at the bottom, you have to, you know, put some depth, okay? For what? For the collection of the grits. Okay, order for the collection of the grits, whatever inorganic grits you are getting from the detritus tank. So you have to provide a depth of, you know, like 0.45 meter you can provide. So you have to add all the freeboard and the space below the, you know, tank. You have to provide, and you have to add all the depth, then you will get the overall depth of the that retest tank, that is here they are getting, you know, 1.95. Okay, so finally the this one is solved, that you are getting the width as your 1.7 meter, the final depth is your 1.95 meter. Okay, and 24 meter is the length of the tank. So finally the numerical is solved. Okay, so coming to the next one, next, and for today it is the last one, that is your skimming tank. Okay, so skimming tank, you know, you have removed the grits. Okay, now what is present in the wastewater? You know, in the wastewater, oils and greases are also there. We have studied it while studying the characteristics of the wastewater, right? So, you know, there is one special kind of tank also for removing the oils and greases from the wastewater. Okay, so this skimming tanks, the name is your skimming tank. So these skimming tanks are, you know, they are used for removing the oils and greases from the wastewater, and they are generally provided, usually provided before the sedimentation tank, because after your skimming process, after your skimming treatment, skimming tank treatment, your next treatment is your sedimentation treatment. So before your sedimentation part or sedimentation treatment, your skimming tank is provided. Okay. So here, you know, like the sewage that is containing all these oils and greases, which comes from the, you know, kitchens and, you know, kitchens of these restaurants, or from your houses, or from industries, or you can say from oil refineries or your factories. So from all those, you know, places from where these oils and greases, they come from. So these are all removed in the skimming tank. Okay, and this actually from the industrial wastewater, whatever the industrial wastewaters are coming, so they contain a very large amount of your these oils and greases. Okay, and these oils and these greases, if they are supposed not removed from the sewage, so what will they do? They, you know, they will you know, form a kind of a scum. Or this, and this scum may be very very you know, of a bad smell. Okay, so and they will enter the, you know, whatever further treatment units are you are going to use, so they will enter all those treatment units, and they will form a scum on this, you know, at the top surface of the settling tanks, and obviously they will interrupt you know, for the other treatment processes, they will interrupt the working mechanism of those treatment processes. Okay, so that is finally that is the main working mechanism of your skimming tank. Okay, so next is your okay, and in a skimming tank, you know, like the detention period of about 3 to 5 minutes is usually sufficient. So here, what is the detention period that is kept? That is your 3 to 5 minutes. Okay, and also you know, here in this skimming tank, actually some air is given with the help of some machines. So this air, this compressed air, it is kept about like 300 to 6000 meter cube per million liters of the sewage. So this is the value. Okay, and you know, whatever sewage, whatever, you know, like the oils and greases that you are getting from the wastewater, or which are removed as the skimmings from this skimming tank, so they are finally you know, disposed by, you know, like burning, by burning also you can dispose it of, or by burial, by doing burial also you can dispose of these skimmings. Okay, and actually these skimmings, they are very polluted, so you have to burn it or you have to bury it. Okay, and sometimes also what happens, you can, you know, like convert it to some non-edible products also. You can convert it in some industries, or like you can also convert it to some, you know, soap lubricants or some candles, and also this non-edible products also you can convert it. And sometimes it is also like in a digester, it is also digested. Okay, so and one another type of this one is also there. Equipment is also there by which you can remove these greases. So that is a vacuator, or you can say vacuum flotation method, you can say. So this grease can, it can also be removed, you know, by this vacuum flotation method. Okay, so here, you know, the sewage, the aerated sewage means what? In the sewage in which does this air has already been blown to it. So this aerated sewage, it is, you know, subjected to a vacuum pressure of somewhat like 0 to 25 centimeter of mercury is there. And you, if you subject it to a vacuum pressure for about 10 to 15 minutes in a this vacuator, so this is a, you know, like vacuum flotation method. Okay, so due to this, what will happen? These air bubbles, they will, you know, move upward. Okay, they will move upward through the sewage, and by this method, you can remove the skimming. Okay, then you can remove the greases that are present in the your sewage or the wastewater. Okay, so next is your sedimentation. So sedimentation. Okay, let me just give you a rough idea of what is sedimentation. Just wait. I am giving you the this link of the attendance form. You will find it in the chat box, you see. I hope everybody has got the link. You fill up this link, okay? And this link will be closed by 10:15 a.m. Okay, after that, I will not allow any attendances. By 10:15, it will get closed. So you do it before that. Okay, so just giving you a brief idea of the sedimentation tank. So like, you know, these screens and these grid chambers, we have already discussed that it removes your all the floating materials, or also that these inorganic settleable solids, it removes, isn't it? But, you know, like there is a part of the inorganic, you know, suspended solids, it's there, which are, you know, like they are not very heavy, that's so that it can be removed as floating materials also. And it is not that light also that it can be, you know, usually it can be removed by a grid chamber. So those kind of, you know, suspended organic solids, which are neither very heavy or they are neither very, you know, very light. So those kind of organic matters, it can be removed by a sedimentation tank. Okay. So these sedimentation tanks, they are designed to remove a part of this organic matter that is coming out from the grit chambers. Okay, so this is a, just a brief idea of the what is a sedimentation. So next class we will be doing all in details about the sedimentation process. Okay, so you please fill up the form. Okay, 20 responses I have got, others I don't know. Let me share in the your WhatsApp group also. Okay. Okay then, everyone, meet you in the next class. So if you have fill up the form, you can leave the meeting. Thank you.